Home Sweet Home, written and read by Andrew Wagstaff. Chapter 1. The silence of space was disturbed by the battle saucer Melek as it exited hyperspace. It engaged its sublight drives and moved into the Skerrin system, the new home of Conquest Army Zero. On the bridge, all was normal. Captain Veer oversaw his crew. First Officer Dahl joined his captain.
"You seem concerned, Captain."
Daleks could read each other's vital signs, overlaid on their main display screen inside their travel machines. Veer shifted, then turned to face his first officer.
"Are you familiar with Conquest Army Zero?"
Veer asked. Dahl thought for a few moments.
"They are commanded by General Ryuk, the first of the two hybrids of Project Eden, recently assigned this newly formed Conquest Army."
Veer nodded his eye stalk.
"And what makes this Conquest Army so different?"
If a Dalek could shrug, Dahl would have, but instead he gave a blank stare.
"It is comprised of anomalous Daleks, Daleks to whom the processing procedure does not hold. They have a full range of emotions, and while some are stable, others are less than."
Dahl looked out of the window at the planet Skerra.
"This Conquest Army was formed at the command of the Emperor himself. It was not suggested by the hybrid Ryuk. It was only after he proved the reclaimed Daleks could be of use to the Empire he was given more of them."
Veer thought for a moment.
"He proved that only he can command them. For some unknown reason, they form a bond with him, similar to the way some lower animal life forms bond with the first creature they encounter when they are birthed."
Dahl didn't like where this conversation was going, to even suggest the servant of the Emperor could betray the Empire.
"You are suggesting he would use them against us?"
Several Daleks on the bridge turned to face Dahl.
"It is a possibility. His humanity may dominate his Dalek nature. His defection could deal the Empire a serious blow."
Before Dahl could reply, the communications terminal lit up. The Dalek manning the terminal turned to the captain and first officer.
"Captain, we are receiving a transmission from Skerra Control."
The Dalek moved out of Veer's way, who took his place at the terminal and unmuted the communications link.
"This is Captain Veer. Speak."
There was a pause.
"Captain Veer, your ship has been granted landing clearance. Due to the unstable nature of the terrain, a hoverbout squadron will rendezvous with your ship. One of our pilots will complete the landing procedure."
Veer's blood started to boil at the suggestion that his crew was not fit to perform a simple landing sequence.
"That will be unnecessary. My crew are all veterans of space travel and combat. We do not require assistance."
"The matter is non-negotiable. You will prepare to receive the pilot."
The Dalek on the other end abruptly terminated the link. Veer turned to the pilot.
"Take us into the atmosphere." "I obey."
The bridge was unusually quiet while the ship made the brief transition from space to atmosphere. At first glance, the planet of Skerra was a tropical paradise, with abundant solar radiation to keep a Dalek's power level satisfied without recharging. The Melek descended gently through the clouds. On the bridge, the silence was broken by a communications chime. The comms Dalek activated the link.
"Battle saucer Melek, this is Hoverbat Squadron Delta, with assigned pilots, requesting landing permission."
The captain moved to the communications terminal and waited for a few seconds.
"Repeat, this is Hoverbat Squadron Delta to Battle saucer Melek, requesting..."
The captain activated the two-way link, cutting the Hoverbat pilot off.
"Hoverbat Squadron Delta, you are assigned Docking Bay 3.
And then he cut the communications link. A minute later, three Daleks entered the bridge, their travel machines painted in the grey and purple of the newly formed Conquest Army Zero, each sporting a crescent moon symbol that, for some reason beyond Veer's understanding, all the Daleks of this army had. Veer moved to greet the three new arrivals. The centre Dalek spoke first.
"Captain Veer, I am Pilot Marks. Due to this planet's unusual atmospheric disturbances, an experienced pilot is required to ensure a safe landing."
The pilot of the saucer turned its dome to face Marks.
"I am a veteran of over 100 years of space travel. I have piloted craft through gravity wells, gas giants, and asteroid fields."
Captain Veer cut in.
"We require no assistance."
Marks considered the two Daleks.
"I have my orders. You will relinquish control."
The first officer approached the group.
"I have checked the standing orders. They state we are now under the authority of the commanding officer. In this case, General Ryuk."
Veer glared at his first officer, but relented and moved to let Marks and the other Daleks onto the bridge. Marks moved up to the pilot station and waited as the pilot disconnected from the control yoke. Marx connected to the yoke and the saucer's systems became available to him.
Connection confirmed. Stegs, take the sensor station. Goa, the auxiliary engineering station.
The two Daleks nodded their eye stalks and moved to their assigned places. The pilot remained close to Marx as the battle saucer began its slow descent to the surface.
What is the nature of the atmospheric disturbances?
The pilot asked Marx, but before he could answer, the ship shook and a large shape flew past the bridge, blocking out the sun temporarily. All Daleks on the bridge turned to the bridge windows, all except for the 3-0 Daleks who remained focused on their tasks.
They are the cause, native reptilian life forms that leave a wake of a as-yet unidentified particle. It is difficult to detect unless you are right on top of it. The particle disrupts power flow and makes flying a saucer in atmosphere rather difficult. If the creatures are responsible, then they should be exterminated,
Via commented. Steyr brought up an image of a downed saucer.
This is what happened to the last saucer who tried to fire at the creatures.
Veyr studied the image, but said nothing. Suddenly, the ship shook violently. Marx fought for control.
Alert! Gravity lenses are losing power, attempting to compensate!
Goa frantically diverted power from non-essential systems, but the power levels continued to drop.
Steyr, keep your optical sensors open!
Marx barked. Steyr rechecked the scanner.
I am! There was nothing on the sensor. It's as if... Alert! Disturbance forming below us! Power level insufficient to slow descent. Impact imminent.
There was a loud clunk, and the noise from the engines began to fade.
Alert! Gravity drives have shut down. The ship is in free fall,
Goa reported. The saucer began an uncontrolled descent to the surface. Marx used the still-functioning thrusters to keep the ship level.
Engineering reports the reactor has shut down. Restart in progress, but it will take approximately 200 rails for power to be restored,
Goa reported.
Proceed with plan Beta 4. Channel all available power to secondary lenses, as it becomes available,
Marx ordered. Goa nodded and turned back to his console. Via moved next to Marx.
We should separate the command module,
Marx turned to face the captain.
We will not abandon ship. Sequence ready,
Goa interrupted. The clouds parted and the surface was clearly visible, coming up to them at an alarming rate. Marx pulled back on the control yoke and the saucer began to glide forward.
Fire secondary lenses!
Veer looked back and forth between Marx.
What will that achieve? The secondary lenses do not have sufficient power to lift the ship in atmosphere.
Marx ignored him as a series of low thuds could be heard as the secondary gravity lenses fired a sequence of short gravity pulses.
Velocity decreasing, Marx stated,
control easing ever so slightly. The gravity pulses continued to slow the ship, and after a few tense moments, the landing struts extended, and the ship gently touched down on the surface of Skerra. The bridge was silent for a moment, as Daleks looked at each other, sharing their relief that they had all survived. Marx disconnected from the control yoke.
I return your ship to you, pilot,
he said, almost smugly, then looked at the captain.
I have left the sequence for the firing of the gravity lenses in your main flight computer. It works in reverse if you have trouble leaving the atmosphere.
The captain studied Marx and the other two. These Daleks, while odd and seemingly un-Dalek-like, had just saved his ship. He thought how best to show his gratitude for his, but all he could manage was,
Your assistance has been noted. The information you have left will be put to good use.
Inside his travel machine, Marx rolled his eye.
There's gratitude for you. Come, we have work to do elsewhere,
he said as he, Stex, and Goa left the bridge.